And the reason it smells so good here is our featured guest this hour took a Philly staple and made it a profitable business, both in Philly and now at your local grocery store. Tony Luke Jr. is CEO of Tony Luke's Pronto. Now, in the 1990s, Tony Jr. worked tirelessly, can't even say that, with his father, Tony Sr., and brother Nick to build the Tony Luke's legend. From lunch trucks to full Italian meal takeout, they tried it all until they hit it with the old Philly-style sandwich formula. And with a savvy eye for marketing and publicity, Tony Jr. has kept the business in the spotlight, making it one of the biggest success stories of Philadelphia dining renaissance of the last two decades. And if that's not enough, Tony's also an actor, appearing in a number of feature films with the likes of Dennis Hopper, Mark Wahlberg, Bill Kilmer, love him, and Brian Dennehy. Tony Luke is here, and he brought food. For all of you watching, I wish you could smell it.
Joe's Max Ferris stole a sandwich, just FYI, so thank you for that.
You have such an amazing story because you are actually somewhat of a Renaissance man. You're an actor. You got this business going on. Your true love is music.
Yes.
So where do you go from here with all this?
My father used to say I'm not good at any one particular thing. So that's why I do a lot of different
things. Jack of all trades, master of none. That's what I say all the time about myself. But you started out as a kid. You guys had a truck.
We had a lunch truck. My father used to go to different stops in the city. Then it wound up being a commissary where the lunch trucks would come. And I never really liked that business. That was never for me. You know, I was always a creative kid. I always wanted to do something different. You know, music was my first love, and I did a lot of stuff in the 80s. I wrote for a lot of different bands and produced a lot of different bands. And then I got into the film industry and did some work there. But then in 1992, we opened up the first Tony Luke's on Oregon Avenue. And, you know, nobody knew who we were. I mean, opening up a cheesesteak place in Philadelphia in 1992 was like,
insane.
Who cares? Right.
It's insane.
It's like opening a pizza place down in Little Italy.
Right. Who cares?
If you're from the South, that's what it's like.
Right.
Sort of.
So I always thought out of the box. So the problem was, how do I get everyone to look over here? So the one thing that I do enjoy doing and I kind of excel in is marketing. Mm-hmm. I always thought out of the box, and I wanted to take that concept to the store. Now, my father and my brother always believed in doing things the right way, never giving out food that you wouldn't eat yourself. So the quality of the food was there. It was getting them to look. So I started doing these really outrageous commercials that really had nothing to do with food. And we wouldn't show the product, we wouldn't show the store. These were just insane commercials mentioning Tony Luke's. And it grew such a cult following in the colleges that the store started to grow at a very rapid pace. By the second year that we were open, we had won Best of Philly for Best Cheesesteaks, Best Roast Pork in Philadelphia Magazine, which was a huge boost for us.
Right.
Then we won Gourmet Magazine and GQ's Golden Dish Awards, and things started to spiral. And then I did the TV Food Network stuff and
Man versus Food
and the Throwdown and Dinner Impossible. And it just kind of snowballed, and my music started again, and the movie started to kick in when I did the character that gave me the most attention, which led to The Nail, which is my new film, was a film called Invincible with Mark Wahlberg.
We have to talk about
that. Hold that thought, Tony Luke Jr.